The University of Vermont is known as UVM, which stands for Universitas Verdes Montes, Latin for the University of the Green Mountains. Burlington, Vermont is the home of the Catamounts, but where exactly are we located? Vermont is part of New England on the northeast coast of the United States. Burlington is known as one of the most exciting small cities in America, and it's located just 3 hours from Boston, less than 2 hours from Montreal. The Burlington Airport offers direct flights to New York City, Chicago, Atlanta, Philadelphia, Washington, D.C., and seasonal service to Toronto. Nestled along a breathtaking landscape on the shore of Lake Champlain, Vermont's mountains are home to 18 ski resorts. Burlington is alive with culture and an urban atmosphere. This lakefront city is home to a thriving downtown scene, complete with dining, shopping, and entertainment. Burlington is one of the top 10 safest mid-sized cities in the country. Vermont has one of the greenest, most environmentally friendly college campuses in America. There are 39 residence halls, and most student athletes live within a minute's walk from the athletic complex. The athletic complex is home to the Student Athlete Success Center, providing a quiet place to study in and around class breaks and practice times.
We're very proud of the academic achievement of our student athletes, and we have a lot of support systems in place to help facilitate that, including a Student Athlete Success Center right here in Patrick Gym where our students can come and study. We help arrange tutors for them, subject area tutors, learning skills tutors, and in general we help them navigate the university so that they can achieve their academic goals.
We have many outstanding leaders among our student athletes, and we host a variety of opportunities for them to hone their leadership skills, including a first-year life skills class. We have workshops around leadership development, and we do community and campus outreach.
Our student athletes also have tremendous support from the athletic medicine staff.
The athletic medicine staff is part of the university's Center for Health and Well-Being. We're comprised of 8 full-time certified athletic trainers and a team physician. Each athletic trainer is assigned a team and covers them medically at home and on the road, in season and out. We strive to provide the most timely, optimal care for our student athletes.
One of the biggest assets to the Catamount experience is the state-of-the-art Athletic Performance Center and its staff.
This 11,000 square foot facility is one of the largest in the Northeast and provides us with a great space to train our athletes. In it, we have 7 Olympic platforms, multiple racks, a 30-yard sprint turf, a large open area that we use for warm-ups and agility training, as well as a whole host of other equipment that we use to train our athletes. The workouts are tailored to each sport by the team's athletic performance coach, and we go beyond just lifting and strength training in an effort to develop overall athleticism.
The last decade has seen Vermont rise to prominence in the New England basketball scene. Over the last 10 years, the Catamounts have posted 8 20-win seasons, won the American East Championship 5 times, earned 8 postseason berths, and won 218 games, which is second best among the 20 Division I programs in the region. Vermont's success has been greatly aided by standout players who became household names. One cannot talk about Vermont basketball without the names TJ Sorrentine, Taylor Coppenrath, and Marcus Blakely coming up. Between the three of them, they were named American East Player of the Year 6 times. Longtime head coach Tom Brennan knew he had something special when Sorrentine and Coppenrath stepped onto campus. Vermont basketball would never be the same again. After reaching the championship game just once in the last 25 years, the Catamounts won 3 consecutive American East titles from 2003 to 2005. The 2005 season was a year that will live forever in Catamount country. With ESPN's The Season following the Catamounts' every move, Vermont didn't miss a beat. Coppenrath, Sorrentine, and a group of 3 other seniors helped Vermont post a school record 25 wins, winning the American East regular season title and then running away with a 23-point win in the championship game against Northeastern at Patrick Gym. Vermont entered the NCAA tournament as a 13 seed and were slated to play Syracuse in the first round in Worcester, Massachusetts. Sorrentine scored 17 points, including 5 three-point field goals, one which will remain entrenched in NCAA tournament lore, as he nailed a deep three-pointer with 1:10 left in overtime. The Cats won 60-57 to earn the program's first win against a ranked opponent in Coach Brennan's final season with the Catamounts. The following season, Mike Lonigan took the reins and built off the momentum created by the Catamounts' upset win. In 2010, the Catamounts were poised to return to the NCAAs. With Marcus Blakely back for his senior season, there was a sense of urgency in Burlington that the Catamounts needed to get it done after a series of early exits the last two seasons. Vermont didn't disappoint. The Catamounts matched their school record of 25 wins and earned the right to once again host the championship game at home. In the championship, Blakely had a monster game with 24 points and 18 rebounds to lead Vermont past Boston University and back into the NCAA tournament. Vermont would lose a tournament rematch that season against Syracuse, but Blakely wasn't done just yet. At the Final Four, he won the dunk contest, further showcasing the program on the game's biggest stage. In 2011, the Catamounts won the regular season title and competed in the team's second ever NIT. Vermont had a game-winning buzzer beater rim out in what would turn out to be Coach Lonergan's final game with Vermont. John Becker, a member of Lonergan's staff, was tapped to replace him and keep the momentum in the program going. Becker hit the ground running with the Catamounts as he became just the fifth coach in AmeriEast history to earn 20 or more wins in his first season. After a 13-win league season and two tournament wins, the Catamounts were headed to Stony Brook for the title game. Vermont held Stony Brook to a conference title game all-time low shooting percentage of 29.3, as Vermont punched its ticket to the tournament for the fifth time with a 51-43 win. In the NCAA tournament, the Catamounts drew Lamar in the first four. Vermont went on a 13-0 run in the first half and never looked back, locking up the program's second ever NCAA tournament win, 71-59. The Catamounts fell in the second round to top-seeded North Carolina. But with Vermont returning four of their five starters, the future of the program was clearly in good hands. In the 2012-13 campaign, Vermont went 21-12, hosted the AmeriEast Championship game, and earned its fifth straight postseason appearance in the CBI. Coach Becker became just the fifth AmeriEast coach to reach the championship game in each of his first two seasons. For Vermont, the players and coaches may have changed over the last 10 years, but the unprecedented run of success has continued. Vermont is home of two of the most storied sports playing surfaces in the state. 50 years of athletic tradition resonates in the stands and on the ice at Gutterson Fieldhouse and on the hardwood court of Patrick Gym. In 2005, a brand new field hockey surface was built, Moulton Winder Field. The next wave came in 2011 with an indoor turf field and the Frank H. Lavac outdoor track. The latest addition to Vermont Athletics is Virtue Field, home of soccer and lacrosse. 360-degree views of all the facilities and answers to your questions are available at uvmathletics.com. Thanks for checking out the Catamounts.